In this video, we're going to look at the basics of browsing the internet with Safari. This includes basic navigation, how we can show and hide the address bar, how we can use the address bar to search. We're also going to look at how we can refresh the page, change the text size, open links, and then we're going to go into tabs. Tabs are basically how we can manage multiple browser windows. On the iPhone, they're called tabs. Now, before we get started, if you like what you see here, stick around to the end. I'll tell you a little bit more about myself and how you can help support my efforts in creating these videos. All right, let's get back to Safari on the iPhone. So I'm looking at my iPhone here, and I'm going to open up Safari. Safari is the default application. It's an Apple app that allows you to browse the web. So let's go ahead and tap on it to open up. And it is my preferred browser. I don't use Chrome or anything else on the iPhone. I basically just use Safari. All right, let's open it up to see how this all works. I tap on it. And I'm looking at a web page here. Now, this is from Wikipedia, and it's on Steve Jobs. Not that that really matters, but we're going to see how the links work and everything else with this. But first, let's take a look at this interface. So I'm looking at this web page. This web page here is contained right in there. And when I swipe up, you're going to see I can view more of that web page. I swipe back down to get back to the top. Now, if we look, when I swipe up, what's going to happen is this address bar, which is located at the bottom, this address bar will disappear. What it's going to do is it's going to move down, and you're no longer going to see it. So I'm going to swipe up and watch this area in here. I swipe up, and we can see it disappears. So how can you get that address bar back? Well, basically, all you need to do is just swipe back down. So I swipe back down, and you can see that it is back. So if you need to get to that address bar, all you have to do is just swipe down if you do not see it. All right, let's take a closer look at this address bar. This address bar is where you go and type in the web page that you want to go to. It's also where you can search. You don't have to go to google.com. You can just use this address bar here to search. So let's see how that works. I'm going to tap on it. So all I have to do is just tap in this area here, and when I do, the keyboard pops up, and I can type in a web page. So if I wanted to go to one of my favorite sites, Dan's Tutorials, of course I'm a little biased, but let's just go to Dan's Tutorials here. I start typing it in, and being that I've been there before, you're going to see that it pulls it up. I don't have to type in the entire name. If you've been there before and it's in your history, Safari will pull that out, and then you can easily just go to that site. Now, you could just keep typing on the keyboard, but if you want to go to the site, all you have to do is just tap on Go here, and it's going to go to that site. We can also see it up here at the top. So let's just tap on Go, and when I do, it goes to my site. I want to go to a different site. I tap on this area here. It brings up the keyboard, and you can type in another site. Now, in addition to that, this is also how we search. I don't have to actually go to google.com to search. By default, Safari uses Google as its search engine. So really, all I have to do is just type in here what I'm searching for. So let's just go ahead and type in here Steve, and we're going to go with Wozniak. So I type in here Wozniak, and you're going to see that it is pulling up different suggestions. And if we look here, you're going to see that the suggestions are coming from Google. So again, I don't have to go to google.com. I can just go and type right in here. Now from here, what I can do is I can tap on any one of these to go to it, or what I could do is I could just tap on Go here, and it'll search for whatever is in here. So let's just go with Wikipedia. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go Wozniak, and then I just type in Wiki, because I want the Wikipedia. And I just type in Go here, and when I do, it searches Google, and then the first result here is Steve Wozniak. I tap on that, and now I'm going to Wikipedia, and I'm looking at that web page. So in addition to bringing us to a website directly, we also use this for search. All right, now when we're on a web page, what we're able to do is zoom in and out. Now, I'm not talking about changing the text size. All I'm talking about is just zooming in and out. To zoom in and out, we just pinch. So I'm going to pinch here to zoom in. and we can zoom in. And then I pinch to zoom out, and it zooms out. Now, right now, this is at its full page. So if I wanted to zoom out further, what this is going to do is it's going to take me to my tabs. And I'll talk about tabs in a little bit. But if I just pinch one more time, so I'm going to pinch to zoom in a little bit, you're going to see it brings me to my tabs. I only have one tab open. More on this in a little bit. But basically, you just tap on it to open it back up. I pinch to zoom in and out. Now, as you can see, this zooms in and out on the entire web page. Well, let's say I wanted to increase the size of the text. How can I do that without having it go off of the display? Well, in order to do that, we need to go to our page view options. Where is that? Well, it's in our address bar here, so we have to show the address bar. So if you don't see it, just swipe down until we see our address bar. And then what we do is we go over to this icon here. This is our page view options. And one of the options when we tap on it is to increase the text size. So now I just tap on the A's to make it larger. You can see it's down here, and I can see the effects on the web page. Right now it's back at 100%. I want to make it smaller. I can do that as well. So we just tap on those to make the text size larger. So it's not zooming into the page per se. What it's actually doing is changing the text size. Another thing that you may want to do is refresh the page. Maybe the page isn't fully loading. You go to a website and the page just stops loading. Well, in order to refresh the page to have it load again, all we need to do is just swipe down. And when we do, you're going to see a little icon up here. And that icon is telling that it is refreshing. So I'm going to swipe down here and look in this area right down here. Swipe down, and you can see there's a little circle there, and now it just refreshes. So I just swipe down, and it refreshes it. So if you're down towards the bottom of the page, and all of a sudden it stops loading, all you have to do is just go to the top, swipe down, and it reloads. Another way of doing this is by tapping on the refresh icon here. This is located in the address bar. So if you are down in the page a little bit and you want to refresh it, just swipe down a little bit to get that address bar to show. So I'm going to swipe down a little bit. I have my address bar here. And now all I have to do is just tap on this little icon here, and it'll refresh it. All right, let's take a look at how we open links. To open links, all we have to do is just tap on it. So if I wanted to open this link here, of course, we just tap on it and it opens it up. Now, Safari does have a contextual menu. If you're not familiar with contextual menus, this is what you see on a Mac and a PC when you right-click on a mouse. Or on the Mac, you control-click on it. You get a little menu that pops up underneath the cursor. Well, we have the same thing on the iPhone. Basically, all we have to do is just long press on it. So I'm going to long press on this article here, or this link here. And when I long press on it, I get a contextual menu. Now, with Safari, this contextual menu shows me a preview of that web page. I can also just tap on open, and it'll open it up. It's just like tapping on the link. And then I have another option here. I can open it up in the background. Now, what does this mean? Well, basically, what this is going to do is this is going to open it up as another tab in the background. So now let's talk about tabs a little bit. You may be familiar with tabs when you're talking about browsing on the PC or the Mac. What you're able to do is have several browser windows open, or I should say a window can have several tabs. Let's go over to my Mac and see how this works. So I'm looking at my Mac here. I'm going to open up Safari. I tap on it. I have a new browser window. Let's go to Wikipedia again. We're just going to go to the same web page. Or the same website, I should say. I'm going to go to English here. So I'm looking at Wikipedia. Now, right now, this is one window, one tab. And what I'm able to do is tap on the little plus over here. And then when I do that, what it does is it adds another tab. So you can see that I'm still in one window here, but I have multiple tabs. Let's go ahead and add another one. We're going to add a few more in here. So now I have one, two, three, four, five tabs. And each one of these tabs can be open to a different web page. So I can go to Yahoo here. This one can go to CNN. I'm just clicking on these. Let's go to Apple News here. We'll go to Apple. And let's go to Dan's Tutorials. So now each one of these tabs here are open to a different website. And to go to a different tab, I just click on the tab. So that's basically how tabs work on the PC. It works the same way on a Mac or a PC. It doesn't really matter what browser you're in. They basically all work kind of the same way. It's one window with multiple tabs. So now, how does this work on the iPhone? Well, let's go back over to my iPhone and see how this can work. I'm going to go to my iPhone here. And now what I would like to do is open up a window in a new tab, or even just open up a new tab. Well, in order to do that, all we have to do is, let's just go ahead and open up a new tab, like what I did on my Mac. I go to the little tab button here. And when I tap on that, what I'm able to see are all of my open tabs. Now, right now, I just have one window open. But what you're going to see here is a little plus here in the lower left-hand corner. And when I tap on that, look what it does. Just like on the Mac, it opens up a new window and it's a new tab. So now, what do you think you're going to see when you go to this little tab button here? I'm going to see two tabs. One, two. So now, let's just go ahead and add another tab. I tap on the plus. And now I have three. So when I go over here, you're going to see one, two, and three. And I tap on any one of those to open it up. So let's just go ahead and tap on this one here. And now if I want to go to CNN, I tap on CNN. And I'm looking at CNN. I want to go to one of my other tabs. I tap on this. And I can go to another tab. So let's just open up this one to Yahoo. Tap on it. We go over to Yahoo. And now I have those three tabs open to different web pages. Now, it's kind of clunky to go down here, tap on it, and then go to another tab. It's a few different steps. I mean, it's not difficult, but it's kind of clunky. I want to go to another page. I have to go down here, and then I have to tap on another page. There's an easier way to switch between your open tabs. So I have three tabs here. All I have to do is just go to the address bar here and swipe back and forth. And when I do, what it's going to do is it's going to switch between those tabs. Think of those other tabs as open right here. So if I had five different tabs open, basically when I swipe back and forth here, what it's going to do is it's going to change between those. All three or all four of these, five of these are going to move. A little bit of a scribbly mess there, but I think you'll get the idea. So now I'm just going to swipe back and forth here and watch what happens. It's just going between those tabs. So I just have those three tabs, and we can see it's just going between those. So all you have to do to switch between your open tabs is just go and swipe there on the address bar. I'll also show you how you can easily open up links in a new tab. This is one of my favorite tricks. So let's just say I'm going to go back over to Wikipedia. And let's just say that I wanted to open up this page here in a new tab. How can I do that? I don't want to have to copy the link, open up a new tab, and then paste it. It's kind of clunky. Well, all we have to do is just go back to our contextual menu. So I long press on it. And when I do, instead of tapping on open, I don't want to do that. What I want to do is I want to tap on open in background. What this is going to do is open up this page, the link, in the background. It's going to open up as a new tab in the background. So instead of having three tabs open, I'm going to have four tabs open. So let's go ahead and do that. Tap on open in background, and it just opened up in the background. Let's go and do that one more time. We're going to get up to five tabs. So I'm going to go to this link here and long press, and then we go to open in background, and it opened up in the background. So now I have five pages, right? Well, let's just double check that. We go over to my tabs and look what we have. Five pages. They open them up in the background. So here they are. These are the two new ones here. So now I can tap on any one of them. And again, if I want to switch between them, remember, I have all five of these sitting right here. And I'm able to go back and forth between them by just swiping. So I swipe, and I can go between my open tabs. So if you want to open something up in a new tab, just long press, open in background, and then you can just swipe to go to that page. That's generally how I browse around with Safari. I use those tabs, and then I'm able to move between them just by swiping on the address bar. Now, what about closing tabs? How can you close these windows, these tabs? Well, basically, all you have to do is just go to all your open tabs. A couple ways to do this. Go to all your open tabs, and then you're going to see a little X here in the corner of each tab. I tap on that X to close it. So let's just go ahead and tap on this one here, and it closes that tab. So now I tap on this X here. We now have four tabs. I mentioned that there was another way to do that. Well, what you're able to do, I'm going to tap on done here. Also, what you're able to do is long press on this, and then when you long press on it, you can close all your open tabs. And don't be surprised if you see tens or and maybe even hundreds of tabs that you can close here. So this is an easy way of closing all of your tabs. Now let's take a look at a private window. How can you open up a page in a private window? Well, in order to do that, basically what you have to do is open up a new private tab. That's what they're called in Safari, a private tab. So if I wanted to open up a new private tab here, just tap on the little icon here to get to my tabs. And then you're going to see private here. I tap on that. And now, when I go to done, I'm in a private window. It's like incognito in Chrome. We can see it changes the color. It has a little darker color, so I know that I'm in a private window. To go back to being just a standard window, I tap on this. And now I go over here to my four tabs, and I'm looking at my four tabs. There is a shortcut for this as well. You can long press on this, and when you long press on it, you're going to see the option to create a new private, a new private tab. I tap on that, and it'll create a new private tab. So that's the basics of how we browse around the internet with Safari. We have our address bar that will disappear when we're scrolling around. Just swipe down to bring it back up. The address bar also doubles as our search using Google search. We can zoom in and out, and we can change the text size. We're also able to open up links in the background. When you do that, it opens up in a new tab. And speaking of tabs, we're able to easily switch between our open tabs just by swiping left and right on the address bar. And if you wanted to open up a new private window, you can do that as well. It's just called a new private tab. Just long press on the tab button and you'll see new private tab. So that's the basics of how we browse around or get around the internet using Safari on the iPhone. Now, if you found this video helpful, what you may want to do is like the video. You can share it with your friends and family. You can subscribe to my channel. It all helps. But in addition to that, you may want to check out danstutorials.com. In addition to having more videos, I also have an AI assistant modeled after an Apple Genius, and I host classes and webinars on a regular basis. So how can you help support my efforts? Well, it is a membership-based site. When you become a member of the site, I take out all of the ads of the videos, so you're not going to see any of those pesky ads. You have access to my AI assistant modeled after an Apple Genius, and you have access to my classes and webinars. In addition to that, you're also helping support a small business. It is just me in a corner office of my house. I'm not part of some large organization. So when you become a member, you are directly supporting my efforts in creating these videos. Check out danstutorials.com for more information, and thanks for watching.